Yo, what is up? Jacob here, and today we are going to build an excuse generator. That's right, we're going to build a website using HTML, JavaScript and CSS, but not normal CSS. We are going to actually learn Tailwind CSS, which is a quite new framework, and it's actually a new way of building websites using CSS, and I'll show you this just in a minute. And it's worth mentioning that this whole video is sponsored by HostGator, and we actually will be building project for them. So let me show you the project first. So this is our excuse generator, and basically whenever you need an excuse, you can get it from here. So we're going to click give me an excuse. So I need more time because, boom, the wireless stack object literally decayed the new matrix. The real data dramatically restored the process heavy interpreter, and so on and so on. And basically those excuses are randomly generated, and that's pretty cool. And also we're going to deploy our app using HostGator service. So you can see that this project is already deployed at doc@mycode.com. So let's get to it. All right, let's get to it. So first we're going to start with creating two files. Basically, we're going to create the index.html and excuse generator.js. So now let's open our favorite editor. So in my case, it'll be Visual Studio Code. And let's create some basic skeleton. Alright guys, so we got a basic structure, just HTML without any magic yet, just a skeleton, and this is how it will work. So basically this is our front end for now, and we want to click give me an excuse, a button, so then it under I need more time because we will get our magic explanation. So this is why I put here empty h1, because we will do some JavaScript logic right now. So after clicking the button, we will get our excuse. So let's code the JavaScript logic right now. All right, so this is basically a very, very simple structure of our function. So basically, we will invoke this function generate excuse each time we click on this button. So this is why I put here get element by ID excuse output. We don't have it yet in HTML. We'll take care just in a few more minutes after installing actual Tailwind CSS to the project. And then we will change the inner HTML for the random sentence and remove the class hidden. Again, we don't have it yet. We'll have it just in a few minutes. And now what are those things here is because we want to generate the sentences. So right now here we have a random sentence and we want to actually generate the random sentence. So right now I'll show you something pretty cool. So the function and the logic which will actually randomize our sentences. So this is what I found on internet. This is how actually get the random element of the array in JavaScript, okay? So as you can see, we can here click rerun, and each time we'll get the random element from this array. And in our case, we want to mix everything together. So get the random adverb, the random verb, adjective, noun. Then we have random sentences. And actually, eventually, we want to get random sentence out of those, out of this array. All right, so let's get this function. Okay, so currently we are getting the random element out of this array, but now we want those sentences also to be random and built from those variables here. All right, so eventually this is how our function look like. Basically, it's a combination of different adjectives, adverbs, verbs, and nouns in their sentences, and basically generating them, taking the random elements and creating the sentences. Okay, so that's pretty cool. And right now, before we actually display this, let's take care of the CSS and our front end. So we're going to the meat of this video, which is Tailwind CSS. So this is the Tailwind CSS main page. And what we want to do is we want to click get started and follow the tutorial how they are actually doing this. So we want to first install it. So here we have our terminal, integrated terminal in a Visual Studio Code. We're going to use this. So let's create, let's write npm install Tailwind CSS. Okay, so as you can see, it created the package log.json, which we don't have to take care of right now. We got the node modules, which we don't really want to have whenever we actually have it in the GitHub, because they are quite heavy. I mean, I'm pretty sure you heard all of the jokes about node modules. You got this thing here, right? Heaviest objects in the universe, sun, neutron star, black hole. Node modules. Anyway, let's get back to the video. So right now we're gonna create the Tailwind CSS file here, and for this we're going to copy those three lines. So we are adding Tailwind to our CSS, and what do we want to actually do also in this video is use our custom fonts. So I already prepared our fonts, and basically this is how we are going to attach them. We're going to write font face twice to actually use those fonts, and the fonts will be also available in the repository and GitHub. So I'm going to actually add them right now to this file. All right, so I just added assets and fonts. So assets is basically the crocodile, snappy, and fonts are basically fonts. And again, you can see them in our repository. So in this case, we have our Tailwind CSS package, and now we need to build the Tailwind config file. So yeah, right now we want to actually create our Tailwind config file, which is usually optional. However, we want to do it because we'll be creating some things in there as well. So as you can see, we got a Tailwind config.js already created. And in this file, what we want to take care of is basically whenever we are going to deploy our application, the default Tailwind CSS file has 2 megabytes. And even if you think it's not that much, for a static website like that, it's actually really, really a lot. And it slowed down the website speed. So we want to get rid of that. We don't need all of the custom CSS written by Tailwind. We just want to extract the CSS which we are going to use in this project. So I'm going to modify this file very quickly and explain it to you just in a second. All right, so here we extended the theme. So basically we added our custom classes for our colors. Those are actually the HostGator colors. And we added our font. And of course, the here, the push is basically, which I was talking about. So whenever we're going to create a production package, then our file won't have 2 megabytes. It will just have, a few kilobytes. So now let's actually write our CSS. So right now we need to use this, this function here. So we're going to build our style CSS out of Tailwind CSS. So here I have Tailwinds. I wanted to say Tailwind. Okay. Tailwind CSS, and the output will be basically, we can write style CSS. Okay, so right now, basically it created the 2.3 megabytes package still, no matter that we configured here, because we haven't set our environment variable for a production yet. And that's good. We for now want to have a whole CSS here so we can play around with it and so on. but later, just before deploy, we will regenerate this file again with actual environment variable. All right, so first let's start with implementing the, adding the CSS style sheet here. So what you're gonna do is link rel is equal to style, href is equal to style.css. Okay, so now as you can see, it immediately changed the, our website for a font which we appended to Tailwind. And now let me show you how cool Tailwind is. Basically, we don't have to write any custom CSS. We just need to operate with classes. So if I do here bg bg, for example, green 500, it will automatically change the background. And so what's so cool about this is there is a nice extension called Tailwind CSS IntelliSense, which will actually give you those nice hints about colors and basically like all of the utility classes. So here, let's do yellow and let's do 100. Now we're going to put this screen, flex column. So we're going to customize our flex box here. Let's do item center. So we'll center everything. And let's use our HostGator color. As you can see, we use the HostGator class color. So this is how simple it is to basically center divs and so on. It's not anymore impossible as it was back in times. I mean, I always had some problems with actually centering stuff when I was using some custom CSS frameworks. Let's actually jump to the logic of our button again. So right now, when we go here to button, so this is our button, right? So there's no class on that and doesn't really work. So we're going to use, give it some life right now. Okay, meanwhile, I had to change Tailwind config.js a little bit because there were some problems with syntax, but it's all fine now. So I still recommend you to just copy this from the Git repo and rebuild the Tailwind here. And now basically our colors are working properly. So here is our current status of our app. So let's continue. So basically this is how our button looks like currently. And what we wanna do is first of all add onClick here. So we're going to onClick, execute the function called generate an excuse, right? Which is here. So this is our function generate excuse. And as we remember, this will change, this will remove the hidden from excuse output and add inner HTML. So here we are, this is our output. We gotta also style it a little bit and add this class. All right, so currently I added the ID excuse output, so it's hidden. And now what happens is whenever we click the button, this will pop up. And as you can see, those are different combinations of sentences with different words inside. So now let's just edit it a little bit. So we got actually, so those sentences will actually have some, like will make sense. All right, so I just added the bank word here for adverbs, verbs, adjectives, nouns, and basically right now, whenever we click, this will all make sense. So let's finish our project with styling the rest of the website with Tailwind CSS. All right, guys, so as you can see, this is our final project. This is our final result. As you can see, this is a beautiful website styled with the Tailwind CSS, and whenever we have an excuse, we can use it. So right now, as I mentioned before, let's create the production package. So instead of 2 megabytes, it will wait just few kilobytes. Okay, it's super simple. So all we gotta do is go to this website, and here they will actually tell us how to do it. So this is you what you saw, what I added to actually our Tailwind config file with the perch. Okay, and now they just want us to set node env to production. So export node env production. Boom, this is done. And now let's rebuild the package. And you'll see that instead of 2 megabytes, we got just 13.5, like 67, of course, kilobytes, which is super light. And our project is actually ready to be deployed. All right, guys, and I just want to mention that when it comes to actual deployment on HostGator, they provide me with one of their nice services. So deployment is as simple as basically uploading files to the public.html file, which they prepared for me. So basically here we already have index.html, CSS, excuse generator, and our packages here. And when we do... when we go to the domain dogmycode, you can check it out as well. Our app is basically deployed here. By the way, guys, you can get your own website set up by clicking the link down below. HostGator has a great tools and resources so you can create your own website exactly the way you want. Just click the link down below, check it out, even if you're starting from scratch, even if it's like your beginning of your coding journey. All right, guys, so that was it for this video. Again, thanks HostGator for giving me this nice opportunity and testing your services plus sponsoring this video. And again, guys, in this video we learn how to build a coding excuse generator using Tailwind CSS, HTML and JavaScript. I hope you like it. Again, the repository is in description. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and see you next time.